Hello folks, welcome back to another video. Today we're checking out Motion. Not Notion, Motion. It is a productivity application. It's a to-do list app at heart, a daily planner app, but it focuses on tasks, calendar, and booking with other people, and it utilizes a bit of AI in there. And we're going to go overview everything you need to know about this application. We're going to start with pricing. So this is probably one of the most expensive to-do list applications on the market, and it is weirdly priced because if you were just billing yourself monthly on this application, it's going to cost you $34 per month, but you're going to have to commit to $19.99 per year if you want a much cheaper price. It's actually cheaper if you're a team user, and that means that you have to have a larger team to get access to that, or else it wouldn't point people towards it. But this will give you access to everything that Motion offers, including the task management, project management, AI, calendar, meetings, booking, one-click email system, desktop app, and dedicated support. And the team give you access to more collaboration with projects. Let's have a look at Motion. And you can see that first things first, the application is really well designed. Like the experience, you can see it's really snappy. And that's something notable with this application. It's only just got a desktop and mobile application, but these are actually fairly fast. You can see the speed. It matters when you're paying something for this application. So this is my week ahead. I can really start planning using time blocking here. So in this case, I could record an event or a task. It automatically it goes to an event because you're on a calendar view. But in this case, I'm actually recording YouTube. So let's add that there. And we'll hit save. So you can see here that once I add a task, it does appear in my task list. And I can go over to projects and tasks and see that I have record YouTube inside of here. Now it's automatically scheduled, which means if anything pops up around this, it actually is like sort of like will automatically rearrange based on things that appear. And this really depends on how much detail you give it. So if I click into it, right, this is really interesting. You can break this down to a lot of different things. Like for example, you can allow split into chunks, which for example is really perfect for methodology like the Bento method, which we created, shameless plug. No, but it is actually something that a lot of people like when it comes to being able to break a task down into sections in a calendar or tasks. And if a meeting interrupts that, then what it will do is it will break into certain elements, but be the same task at its core. Now, what's really nice is the more detail you give a task, the more knowledge that Motion has with its AI to rearrange stuff. So for example, if I put this is high priority and be like, this is a hard or a soft deadline, that gives indications to this task that if something comes along that might be more important, it'll reschedule it. And that's important because if you do have a influx in tasks that somebody may send you or assign to you or you want to do that has come up more important, then that can naturally improve it. Now you can set the deadline as well. You can choose another day for the deadline and that will give a better indication. Start date is today and it can be scheduled out of working hours as well. You can create a schedule as well, which we'll probably do in a moment to explain it. And if I go ahead and press save, that means those parameters have been recalculated. And you can already see instantaneously what it's done is it's removed it from what was previous, I did this purposely, and into today, which is really nice because it understands time has passed and you haven't done this task still. So I'm gonna remove it for you or move it for you. Now let's say if I go ahead and add a task, right, that is, I don't know, we'll call it Bob. Bob is always referred to in these videos. And as you can see, it's broken off an element of the record YouTube because the call for Bob has popped up. Now, one thing that I might want to do is put this on a super low priority and to do within 2 to 3 weeks. If I press save, it recalculates that completely and it puts it on next Monday. But if I were to say ASAP, it's got to be done ASAP and it's got to be done as soon as humanly possible, it rearranges even record YouTube because it prioritizes that above recording YouTube. So you can start to see how this system works. Actually, the more insight you give a task in task detail, the higher quality the decision of the AI will be as time goes on. And what it will do as well is if incoming meetings come up, like if you've hooked up your calendar, if incoming meetings come up, it will automatically schedule it. But you can see here that it's got these like dots around the edge, which means that it can repopulate when needed. Now, as you can see, it's got schedules. And in this case, this is a schedule. I'm actually going to move this about a little bit because my week is not necessarily like this. So in this case, I might say my day starts at 8:30 and ends at 4:15. Tuesdays are normally a lot later. It's 9:15 to a little bit later at 5. And I know Wednesdays I start much later at 10 and finish earlier and start earlier on these days. So you can start to see that my week is slightly more adapted and more flexible. But you've now associated, you can now set it to this schedule of day. So if I go to that one and press save, it shouldn't reallocate stuff because it doesn't need to. But for example, if I was like, if the YouTube one was on a schedule of day and I press saved, there we go. So it'll allow me to work till 4:15. But if it was any later, for example, and I added a task here, call and add a task, if I press that, it should still stay, apparently. But if I give this a really soft or low thing and it needs to be done in a week, it should remove it. There we go. It should remove it and it moves it to Monday. So it should be next week. There we go. So that's quite an interesting set of rules when it comes to task prioritization. And that's really nice for a lot of people because it gives them a little bit of a helping hand of like when stuff is really important. It sometimes is difficult to prioritize, like, okay, what is clearly the focus of the day? So this is really nice function in Motion. And you can even see a day view if you want to. And you can see when the next task is coming up, which is really nice. They do have a little app up here, which allows you to use and access bookings, calendars, and things like that. So that's a really nice feature, but it can get quite overwhelming because you've got loads of stuff in here. And you can see here that the projects information gives a better breakdown of your tasks. You can see it in a Kanban view or a projects that you've got. So you can associate it to a project like YouTube launch. I thought it had a drag function. I might have to bring this into YouTube launch and press save. So if I go back to it, it should have added that one there. Perfect. Now you can add a bit more detail to a task. For example, if you didn't want it to auto reschedule, then you can actually set that there. You can also change details on it and also add blockers when it actually starts as well. You can add an overall project end date as well. So this is perfect if you're looking for like, okay, this one's got to be done by the 21st. And you can also add labels and also give it statuses as well. Now it looks like I've actually just got an update in the bottom right hand corner. So this application looks like it does do routine updates because I actually opened this about 2 days ago and it seems to have an update in there already, which is good news, I guess. So from here, you can utilize templates and you can create your templates from here. To be honest, this view is not as nice as I thought it could be for the price you're paying. You do get Kanban view and you do get the projects view. And of course, recurring tasks can be added as well. If you've got something that comes up routinely, you can do some level of filterization, which is nice. You can see your schedule, what's coming up in more of a week-based view, which is really nice. And you can do things like backlog items. So if I backlog that, let's find it. So it should be in one of the areas around here. I should know where it is. it should appear somewhere here in a moment. Let's see if I've got it. No, I should know where backlogs is. I'll come back to that in a moment when I find it. But you can get an idea for the fact that these have blockers. They don't just have the sort of basics that you would traditionally add to a task. You can also add a lot more detail here, like subtasks, notes, embed images, and subtasks can really break a task down a lot further. You can add stuff directly in here as well if you're looking to just really update it in much more detail. So here we go. If I go to bookings, this is great for a Calendly alternative. You can embed your own booking meetings and you can even generate the message that's set up. But there's quite a high level of detail when it comes to booking. So you can actually have it set to a schedule on the day. You can show the availability of days that you have, and you can also see the availability and starting from as well. This is a really nice function because you don't want to start booking loads of meetings that just randomly pop up. And you can also have a buffer time as well, which is cool. So you can limit the number of meetings that you have per day. That's another really respectful feature. And give a certain meeting priority. And this really assists the AI function, which basically takes that mid priority or high priority and basically go book over everything. This is really important. So you can have a link. You can have like a link like urgent meetings. And that means that every time this one's booked, then it's really clear. And you can even set up like whether you're a host or whether there's a link, and you can rechange this to like urgent and have it in your email. So if I press save, I can actually generate a message with this each time, which is great, and send it to people. So that's really helpful. That basically just gives you all the setups that you need. And you can copy the link. Let's see what it actually looks like in the wild. So this is what it looks like booking a meeting with me. But you can see here that I can actually book in advance, like Wednesday, half an hour, bob@bob.com. And I can schedule the event. So this is really handy when it comes to bookings. So what it's done there is it should have found that in the calendar and it automatically done it for me. And it automatically created a Google Meet as well for us. So there we go. So that's a good example of something that can come up. If I move it over, if I move the task over, obviously they're call Bob. But it actually doesn't rearrange it. Which is strange. I thought it would rearrange it because it's a bit of a clash to some extent. I wonder if I go back and I move something that I had earlier into here and see what happened. So that'll give you an idea for what's coming up at least. Okay, so I haven't worked out why it's not moving anything and why they're sort of clashing. Maybe it's actually because I've titled it Call Bob. Maybe if I change the note to like book calls and press save. Yeah, there we go. I think it was probably to do with the urgency of it. Okay, so you can see that you can book meetings and have that all booked in with Google Meet, and you can join that meeting straight away, which is handy. You can also see when a task is coming up, and you can use keyboard shortcuts to save you a bit of time. Inside the settings, there's quite a range of stuff, and I'm just going to skip down to the auto scheduling function. You can actually organize, reorganize what actually appears on your Google Calendar and on your Motion calendar as well, and what is available in the statuses of the workspaces that you created. There's also a mobile application that you can download using that link, and you can see what your schedules define, what time zones you've got, and what conferencing software that you do have set up. Now, in terms of general use, this application is really well built in terms of its structure. But in terms of practicality, it does take some time to get used to setting up. And it's something that a lot of people will find probably a little bit of time to get used to. One thing that you can do that will show you is do things like Focus Banner. So Focus Banner is something that pops up and gives you a bit of focus. You can even view the details of it just by skipping there and delete it if you want. You can also start the task as well, which starts a timer on the task, as you can see in the bottom right hand corner. Now you can even do things like add due later to it, backlog it, and add a time to the task as well, like more duration and such details like that. Now, you can also go to the project that it's part of as well, or reassign it to a project that it's part of. So for example, if I wanted to assign that to YouTube launch, then I can do, and that means I should see it as part of this over here. Now, you can also copy link if you're sharing it with other people, get rid of that in the top right-hand corner. And one thing I still haven't found, folks, is the backlog ability. Let me find that for you now. Ah, here we go. You can see the backlog items that you created. I haven't created any, but if I were to, I can simply move this one to backlog. And if I go to projects, I can move and find the backlog area, and it should be in there. Ah, I know why it's in the backlog, because it doesn't have any tasks. So if I go to calendar I find it. So if I go to call, I found it. Here it is. Okay, so what happened was the filtering was set up so that the backlogging wasn't showing up. So that's how you backlog, and you can move it out of there to into auto scheduling, which is great because then you can move it into an active zone. Okay, so that was Motion. In general, this application is going to take time to get used to. And to be honest, it's got some nice abilities with calendar, some nice AI functions, and some very simple project management abilities. The fact that you get booking in there is a nice system, but as a price option, it's quite an expensive one when you do compare it to other applications on the market. Although applications like AkiFlow and many of the others like Sensama are looking to move to this sort of pricing. So again, you're sort of like creeping into this world where they're all going to be sort of priced at this, these advanced to-do list applications. Now, if you're interested, you can check out Motion below or explore it further on Toolfinder so that you can get a bit more detail on it. But that was my take on Motion. As you can see, some elements to get used to and a general nice premise for the application for daily planning. So thank you very much, and I look forward to seeing you in a future video. If you want to find a productivity application, check out Toolfinder and jump onto more videos here on Keep Productive. I'll see you very soon. Cheerio.